The first thing that will happen to you as a young man or as a young woman here is that the decision for your life is not in the hands of God. It's in your own hands. The decision to become a success or a failure is in your own hands, not in your father's hands. It is important you know this now, because I'm going to be shaking some tables today. I will break some, I will burn some, I'll throw some away. Because we must leave this poverty, minchomic, mundane, moribund, microscopic mentality. We can't continue like this. I heard an intelligent girl ask a question, how do I become a millionaire? And I bet you, if she ever talks like that in her house, they'll beat her up. Because if your father has never thought of being a millionaire, you dare not say you want to be a millionaire. If that girl was the answer to the problem in their family, they would shut her up that day. The fact that your father was not a millionaire does not mean that you cannot be a millionaire. I came here as an example of something that will happen to you. If you go and tell your mom, "Mom, I want to be a doctor, I want to be an artist, I want to be something," and they tell you to keep quiet, what they don't know they're doing is they're killing something in the inside of you. When you tell your daddy, "Daddy, I like to sing," and your father says, "Keep quiet," they're killing something in the inside of you. Every time they kill something inside of you, it takes a part of your life away. Now, a lot of people that have graduated now have started even doing working in bank, but when they work in bank at night, they go into a small place and begin to practice how to sing, because their passion has always been singing. Their passion has always been singing. Their passion has always been singing. I came to stir that gift in the inside of you. Anything that God has put inside of you, it must come out, because you are a gift to this world. God knew that we needed you. He sent you down. You were packaged by God. You were designed to come and solve a problem in Nigeria. He did not make a mistake putting you in Agege. Agege needed reformation. He put you here so you can see, and you are here to solve a problem. Say, "I hear you." Hear me now. You are between the ages of 13 to 19. You had better find your passion. Passion is anything you can do without praying. When that girl was saying that she doesn't need money to do this thing, I looked at Uncle Kwe, "You're a lucky man. Come and try somebody else." And I said, "Come and cover this. You'll pay 1 million naira today." Because she doesn't understand value, teach her to sharpen and teach her how to sell. Free things kill people. Stop doing free. Passion without motivation is frustration. Come here, girl. Come here. I see the way you bend down with passion here. One day she was taking a picture. This girl was actually on the floor. She doesn't know what money is. I looked at myself. I said, "God, help me. Help her to understand money. Help her. Because when she understands money, there will be a lot of opportunity." Look at her junior sister has taken position there at the age of 6. What do you do now? Hey. At 8 years old, that one knows how to operate a Nikon camera. What do you do now? If you call anybody to take a picture of your wedding, you pay 350,000. So this girl is already 350,000 naira per day worth. Multiply that by 30 days, because if you cannot count, you cannot be rich. That means, as you are seeing here, this girl is valued at 9 million naira a month, 82 million a year. That is her net worth. She is not your mate. You go there. Money does not respect age. The fact that you are taller than her, bigger than her, does not matter at all. Yes, the Bible says money is a defense. Yes. Money gives her options. Money gives her a voice. He that has the money dictates what happens. You need to show yourself the different ways of making money. There are 4 ways of making money. One, as an employee, whereby you work for money. Number 2, as a self-employed, yes, you can do the business. Some of you can do hair. Tell your auntie, "If you are doing your hair, auntie, you pay me 1,000 naira. Charge them. God gave you the gift. Don't do it for free. Self-employed. The third one is owning a business, owning a system. And then the fourth one is an investor. Investor. The picture you see there is Obama's daughter. When Obama was president, he sent his daughter to go and work in a fast food restaurant selling buns and sugar. They didn't tell her to go and live in Dubai. She had to go and learn to work. My children go to learn to work because you must learn how you make money working. But I also teach them how to do business. A poor man will only teach his child how to go and get a job. There are other ways of making money. In the Garden of Eden, there were four rivers entering the garden. Four. If it took God four rivers to water the garden, you cannot be alive and tell me you only need one source of income. If you have only one source of income, you're a poor man. Change your habits. Somebody said, I'm an art worker. I dare you come to pastor here and pay pastor and say, Pastor, this is for you. You will stand on this stage. Stop talking to poor people. If you want to fast track your destiny, look for people that can take you there and associate yourself with them. If you talk to your mate, they don't take you anywhere. If you talk to people lower than you, they pull you down. Look for people that are higher than you. They will pull you up. I know you live in Agege, but trust me, you can live in Amsterdam just by a decision. If anybody tells you that what you are doing is not making sense, tell them I said that is not for their generation.